Hello friends and welcome to this new video. I finally got my iPhone 5 and after a few days of trying it in and out, I can give you a pretty decent review about it and that how it differs with my previous iPhone 4S. So I have here both of them. On my right side is the 4S, you can see it's shorter, and on the left side is the iPhone 5. Now, I have to tell you that right away the first thing you notice is the weight. The one on the left, the iPhone 5, is substantially lighter. And you can feel it when you by just holding it in different hands. Now, of course, the other difference is the bigger screen, which it may not be a very, very definitive factor when you want to switch, but to be honest, it does seem to be better to have an extra long screen, have a little more space, you know, for your apps, and also when you're watching movies and stuff like that. So that's good. The other thing that you notice, and that it probably for me is a minus, is that in the iPhone 5, the sides of the phone are not metallic anymore; they're black, at least in the black iPhone case. And also you'll notice that if you turn the phone around, we have lost the mirror or the mirrored Apple logo. Now the iPhone 5 logo is not a mirror anymore, so I can imagine many people being disappointed. I know it's a minor thing, but probably many girls would really appreciate the fact of having a small mirror here, even if it's tiny, you know, that could be useful sometimes to have it there. So that's for that, but this, besides that little detail, I think I haven't found any major complaint about the iPhone 5. In fact, everything seems to be better. Now, it's faster, so when you open apps and it feels more responsive. It is faster also when you use Siri. So I guess the new chip does give that performance edge over the 4S. So you do have a noticeable speed increase, and again, it's not difficult and noticeable. So what else? Well, the screen is almost the same in terms of quality and clarity, and so not much change on that. Both the 4S and the 5, you can update the 4S to the iOS 6, so you will have all the same features. Now, the other differences, at least when you first get the phone, is the change of connectors. So now, Apple departs from this traditional connector here, the large one, to the new Lightning connector that is smaller. It's still located on the bottom of the phone. Also, we still have on the bottom of the phone the speakers and the microphone. And what does change is the location of the headphone jack. Now, the headphones jack, instead of being on the top like it is on the 4S, on the 5 is on the bottom. So that could be not really a big difference, since you can rotate the phone when you're watching a movie. So, but I actually don't understand why that was done. I kind of prefer it to be on the top, so when you hold your phone like this, you know, it won't interfere the headphone jack with your hand. But again, that's not really that big of a deal. So besides that thing, it does feel more comfortable on the hand. You know, it's more natural. That extra length gives the phone a better grip. It's not a huge difference, but it's you can notice, you notice it a little bit. So, and of course it's a little bit thinner too, so that also contributes for it being lighter. Well, that's it for this video. I just wanted to give my second impression after having the phone myself. My previous videos were with an iPhone 5 of one of my friends, but this one is from myself, and I'm gonna be making other videos about the iPhone 5 compared to the 4S. So please stay tuned, and really thank you for watching.